As I mentioned in one of my previous videos, Fortinet is giving up on SSL VPN. I've done a couple of migrations to remote access IPsec, and it was not nearly as easy as I would expect. Hi, I'm Alex, and this is NextGenLAN channel. Let's make Fortinet remote access IPsec work. Remote access IPsec has way more configurable parameters than SSL VPN, and having just some of them wrong will prevent tunnels from getting up. And all will end up as a troubleshooting nightmare. I tested my configurations using FortiGate firewalls with 7.4.7 firmware version and 3, which is non-EMS, FortiClient version 7.4.2. I strongly recommend you to upgrade yours to at least 7.4-something, as earlier versions had lots of limitations. For example, 7.4 version for macOS didn't even support IKE version 2 at all. So here's a list of what I think works the best. IKE version 2, it provides you faster tunnel establishing, it supports SAML, it supports TCP encapsulation to make it as close to your current SSL setup as possible, it supports split DNS. The only drawback I'm aware of, split tunnel subnets can only be configured in IPsec tunnel configuration, and looks like it cannot be inherited from policies. Also, I strongly recommend you to select only one Diffie-Hellman group. I spent too much time troubleshooting this, and it only works fine when there is only one DH group configured on both firewall and the client side. I'd recommend using group 20 if you don't have any mobile clients like Android or iOS, and 14 if you have, but it's up to you. Just don't use default group 5, okay? In phase 1 and phase 2, just remove MD5 and SHA-1 options. In phase 2, also check that both local and remote subnets are all zeros, and configure policies for IPsec clients using user groups. So let's configure some. Using FortiGate IPsec Wizard is a good idea to save some time, just remember it will not work. Give the new tunnel with remote access type meaningful name. Select incoming interface, preferred tunnel authentication. It is separate from user authentication, and select a group of users. It can be changed or it can be extended later, no problem. Select which internal zones or interfaces users will be able to connect. Again, it only for policies automatically created by Wizard, and it can be changed later. Select all the subnets that will be advertised for split tunneling and allocate a range of IPs for the clients. Select if you would like to keep clients with their system DNSs or you would like to specify DNS addresses. And don't forget to switch enable IPv4 split tunnel if you need it. Select if you would like clients to be able to save their passwords after connect and keep alive the tunnel. Click create and click show tunnel list. Again, don't expect it to just work, it will not. Now select the tunnel you just configured, click edit and push convert to custom tunnel button. Now let's fix everything. Network part should be okay. Just remember that the list in accessible networks is the split tunnel subnet list, and this list must be edited if you want to add or remove subnets from split tunnel. Authentication part, just change IKE version to version 2. Phase 1 proposal, select only one DH group. 14 is safe option, supported by the majority of clients. 20 gives you better encryption. Change all MD5 or SHA-1 options, if any. Important, local ID doesn't actually work for remote access IPsec. If you want separate tunnels for separate groups, you will need so-called network ID, which is only supported by the EMS version of FortiClient. No, local ID doesn't work. Trust me, I tried. And after multiple failures, I checked with Fortinet support and they confirmed. And no, set aus group command doesn't work either. Just use one IPsec tunnel and use policies with user groups to separate access. Phase 2, again, only one DH group. Check that the local address and remote addresses are all zeros and remove MD5 or SHA-1 if any. Don't forget to save, click OK. And no, we're not done yet. Now go to CLI. Type command config VPN IPsec phase 1-interface. Type show and check your just created tunnel. Enter command edit with your tunnel name and type these commands. Set IAP enable, set IAP identity send request. Now you have SAML working and you can use your local username database or SSO or whatever you want for user authentication. If you have SSL VPN configured, you can reuse its account for IPsec now. No need for new one. If you want split DNS, also put these commands with your DNSs and your domains. Set IPv4 DNS server 1 with your IP of your DNS 1. Same for server 2. Set internal domain list with lists of your internal domains separated by space. Type end and close CLI. We are almost there. Now go to policies. There will already be a policy for the tunnel you just created to a zone or interfaces you selected using the wizard. You can edit it as any other policy, create new policies using the same IPsec tunnel as a source and so on. You can just copy-paste your existing SSL VPN policies if you have SSL VPN configured. Just remember that by default that policy has outgoing NAT enabled. Probably you don't need it. And it doesn't have a user group assigned, which I definitely think you should. So in the end, you should have something like the policy on the screen. Okay, done with firewall. Let's configure the client. Select VPN option as IPsec VPN and put details as your configuration and preferred authentication method. In advanced settings, set IKEA version 2. In phase 1, select only one DH group and update proposal values to be aligned with what you set in the firewall config. Same for phase 2. Select only one DH group and align proposals with a firewall. Save and try to login. Should be working. If not, let's continue. If you expect that the new remote access IPsec to work as SSL VPN through a custom TCP port, especially if your VPN terminating firewall is sitting behind NAT by itself, you need some more configuration. Globally, in system settings, set a custom TCP port for IKEA. Important, it affects side-to-side VPN too. So if you have those on the same firewall, it will break connectivity. Be careful. Type these commands. Config system settings, set IKEA TCP port and put the port number you would like to use. And you have to enable TCP transport support for the tunnel you just created. Type commands config VPN IPsec phase 1 interface, edit your IPsec tunnel name, set transport TCP. Traffic that uses TCP as a transport cannot be offloaded to the firewall's NPU. So Fortinet added a custom version that can be offloaded, but it is not supported in case of dial-up IPsec, so let's just keep it. Okay, type end, and let's update the client's configuration. In VPN settings, set IPsec over TCP and select the port number. If you are migrating from SSL VPN, it actually makes sense to allocate a new port to keep the old one for SSL for a period of user migration. Okay, that's it. It's working and everyone is happy. But what if not? What if you did all the configuration, pushed the connect button in the FortiClient and it didn't get anything? No meaningful errors, just timeout while connecting. Then we have to do IPsec troubleshooting, which every bloody time makes me regret being a network engineer at all. By the way, if a client gets frozen in disconnecting, even after you push disconnect button, just close and reopen. For troubleshooting, open firewall CLI and enter these commands. Change the tunnel name to yours. Diagnose VPN IKEA log filter clear. Diagnose VPN IKEA log filter name with your tunnel name. Diagnose debug application IKEA minus 1. Diagnose debug console timestamps enable. Diagnose debug enable. Now try to connect and in the huge output try to find errors or failure messages. For example, if you got gateway validation failed, you most probably forget to add those IAP commands to the tunnel config. If you have issues with DH groups, you didn't follow my advice and tried to use multiple DH groups options instead of just one. The last but not least, What if everything is fine, you configured and successfully tested an IPsec tunnel, but you have to migrate several hundreds users and they definitely do not want to learn what IPsec is and which DH groups they should use and select and why. They needed to just simply work. Okay, I have a solution for you. FortiClient keeps all the configured VPN configurations in the Windows registry. Computer, HK local machine, software, Fortinet, FortiClient, IPsec tunnels. Just configure VPN on a test host, export this section imported to all the clients using Active Directory global policies. All good, all the clients have their new shiny VPN. After some time, push them to IPsec and disable SSL configuration in your firewall. That's it. I hope it was informative for you. Share, like, subscribe. See you next time.